audience please rise and join us in singing the Pledge of Allegiance? There's a flag in the back left corner. All those are there too.
Each learner's path throughout the year should Brooksville, why should potential teachers want to spend thousands of dollars and hours of time in college to get a job playing second fiddle to a computer? You could comment on an even greater teacher shortage with this plan. Please, please, board members, say no if you haven't already. Thank you.
Thank you. Next up, Mr. Turner.
Yes, I appreciate being down here today. It's really been renovated well. It's a hub here in the community. I know Dr. Pratt had a lot to do with that. I happened to be down playing summer, as I was telling her a couple weeks ago. They had a meeting down there, a community affair for 2 to 4 in the afternoon. And I went through the building. It's a beautiful building. And I'm so glad that you kept it, and I know Dr. Pratt again was involved in that, seemed to do it over the last 3 years. It was developed properly. The gentleman who's the pastor of the church now down there, the church has obviously been down there. I'm sure all of you have been down there. And you have seen that it's the church in one gym is the sanctuary, and then the other gym is for kids. And that whole area down there is special to me. I had a lot of friends with Daniel that were athletes and spent a lot of time on the south side. St. John's was across the street from Blaine Summer. It's since been torn down. St. Boniface is closed on the south side. A friend of mine who I coached with, his dad owned a little bar down there, and they always had family parties down there. And that area around Blaine Summer is a hub. Blaine Summer was a hub for that Southside community. And it's refreshing to see that Dr. Pratt and the Board of Education have seen to it that that school has been developed into something rather than sitting there or being torn down. You know, I had an experience in teaching in Harrison. I was very disappointed in the way Harrison was handled. Harrison became a blight on the community. The windows were knocked out. You know, the place was torn apart, and nobody saw to it, but something positive happened to Harrison School. And that was really a tragedy in my estimation since I taught down there for 3 years. Very important, I know Dan Walter went to school here. You know, in 1966, I was the coach here. I was attending Bradley University, and I coached all the sports. We walked up to Morton Square for football and for softball, and played our games right here in this gym. Went undefeated until the last game against Irving, and Irving beat us 66-8. I thought I was a pretty good coach until I got beat 66-8. You know, but if you know the history of this school, there were all Caucasian students or Latin students here. There were absolutely no black students here. The black students walked from Taft Homes up the street to Irving. I don't know how that ever happened. I didn't understand how it happened when I was coaching here. But somehow it got corrected, and you know, that no longer is the case, obviously. The neighborhoods were integrated, basically. So it was really interesting being here in 1966. I want to say again that I'm going to miss Ernestine Jackson. Ernestine's not here today. She's out of town, I believe. And Ernestine did a lot of things in the last 5 years, including being part of bringing Dr. Pratt here, which changed the whole culture of this district. When Lathan was here, this was an armpit, the armpit of the area. And she brought her 10 people in from North Carolina, and the first things they said in the first month of Peoria was dysfunctional. It went downhill from there. And I want to thank this board for all you've done, how all of you contributed to this. You've seen that Peoria has grown in the right direction. You know, we have some decisions coming up, and I hope you make the proper decisions. I hope you save the $6 million from Quest, and you invest that money in our school system. You are better prepared to spend that $6 million in this district than Quest is over there with their own separate board who knows nothing about what's going on. I've shared those things with you before. I'm not going to share them again with you. But I want to congratulate you on all the positive things you've done in the last several years. And this is one of the gems of Peoria, as is Blaine Summer. Thank you.
responses to audience presentations. Next item on our agenda is proposed expenditures over $2,500, an informational item. Any questions for Mr. Wallace on the proposed list? All right, seeing none, we'll move to the consent agenda. Vice President Shaw, would you please read the list?
Thank you, Mr. Adler. The consent agenda consists of the following items. Item number one, human resources report. Item number two, readoption of existing hazard boundaries. Item number three, interim payments. Item number four, resolution approving the Illinois School District Liquid Asset Fund plus certificate deposit program. Item number five, resolution authorizing inter-fund transfers and loans and authority to invest funds. Item number six, tax deductions. Item number seven, resolution designating depositories. Item number eight, resolution approving treasurer's bond. Item number nine, prevailing wage. Item number 10, joint agreement for special education evaluation per case rate. Item number 11, joint agreement for speech pathologist rate during extended school year. And item number 12, memorandum of understanding teen reach program. That is the entirety of the consent agenda.
Thank you, Vice President Shaw. Are there any items that board members would like pulled for a separate vote? Seeing none, can I have a motion and a second to adopt the entire consent agenda? It's been moved by Mr. Wilson, seconded by Mr. Shaw. Any discussion on the consent agenda? Mrs. Ross.
Just a question on number eight, resolution number eight. If I can get a little bit of explanation. I know I think we do this each year, but a little bit of explanation on $15 million.
Item number eight, resolution approving treasurer's bond is a state-required bonding amount for those who are in the position of treasurer. And this is a standard item that is on our agenda annually each year this time of year.
Thank you, Mr. Wells. Any other questions or discussion on the consent agenda? Madam Secretary, would you please call the roll?
Mrs. Ross?
Aye.
Mr. Walker?
Aye.
Mr. Wilson?
Mr. Wilson?
Aye.
Is there Dr. Bob? Yes. Mr. Shaw?
Aye.
And Mr. Adler-Owens?
Six ayes, motion carries.
Six ayes, motion carries. Thank you very much. This brings us to presentations and suggestions by board members. Outside of the recognition for Mrs. Jackson, do any board members have any presentations or suggestions? Seeing none, we'll move on to recognition of Mrs. Christy Jackson, a retiring board member. Who wants to talk first?
Just a quick reflection, so to speak. Sorry that Christine wasn't able to make it. We spoke briefly while she was gone, while she is gone. And I just want to say I've known Christine over 30 years. And for this entire time, her tenure as far as being in Peoria, as long as I've been in Peoria, has been to stand for what is right for people and stand for people who couldn't ordinarily stand for themselves, particularly children and families. Her passion was to promote better conditions for our people, and promote education. She's always stood for education as a part of the NAACP for, I don't know how many years, I call it, and my mother used to say, umpteen years. She always stood for making changes that would benefit those that were less fortunate. I think I can rightfully say that she did as much as laying down in front of cars to try to get some equal rights for jobs and that kind of thing. So as long as I've known her, she's always stood for equality. And then since we've been here, we learned a lot about equity, which is two different things. We understand that. So I'm sure that she'll continue to fight for what's right for people.
Yeah, Ernestine had some travel issues. She couldn't be here, but here's some of these accolades. But I ran against Ernestine 4 years ago, and Ernestine defeated me in that election. And then the next following year, when I was elected, I worked with Ernestine on the school board. And then the year after that, we were on the building committee together. And there were times we would agree to disagree, but she was always a class act and very well informed. And more often than not, on the building committee, we agree. Ernestine and I both had some concerns about access to some of our buildings, handicapped access. And she was a constant reminder to the building and grounds people that, you know, these places aren't there, and if they would get back to it, she'd get back to them. And so, it was just like Mr. Ross said, she was an advocate for those who couldn't help themselves. She was there to help her, and she will be missed.
So, if I could sum up Mrs. Jackson in one word, it would be accountability. She held our vendors and suppliers accountable, she held the district accountable, and she held herself accountable. She made no excuses, she came prepared, she was well prepared and ready to fight if necessary, and I think we're going to miss her presence on this board. I wish her.
I'd like to thank just pretty much every other board member has said so far. You know, one of the biggest things that I always love Ernestine for is our heart. A lot of times, it's hard to judge what somebody is really doing community work for. Sometimes it can be to push an agenda. Other times it is truly to help others. Ms. Ernestine, there's no denying that it was to help others. And for that, all this love for that. So.
It's really good, like an add to what my colleagues have said so eloquently. I'm tempted to just let it go at that, but that wouldn't be right. It was not Mrs. Jackson's job to teach me what she did. And I tried to listen. And I think I learned a great deal. It's much more personal than the larger picture that you just heard. I am grateful for the lessons learned, and I think I'm a better board member because of it. And I think Mrs. Jackson, we're sitting here, she'd be nodding back at me because I think while the bulk of the learning ran towards me, I think there was a little time bit that I, frankly, all my colleagues have to offer as well. And it was within her curious and generous nature to take all that in. And I'm going to miss her.
But you don't know necessarily what gifts everybody's going to bring. was her tenacity and her get after it mentality for improving our schools and helping out our students. I met with all the board members in the last month or two and had a little conversation about how they thought the year went, her state included. She gave me a very big list of to-do items, and she mentioned to me over the weekend that she had a lot of things she wanted to say here today, but unfortunately couldn't make it back, and she expects to be at the next board meeting, reminding us of all the things that we need to do better on from the podium and the public eye. So I appreciate her greatly, and have enjoyed working with her. Legislative session, if you will, of this school board, and